Hey guys, how's it going? Zombie here with ZNR Gaming, and today we're looking at Ghost Recon Wildlands, guys, and we're looking at the new event that starts tomorrow, the Terminator event. Now, I'm making this video kind of late in the day, so when I say tomorrow, you guys probably won't see this video until the event actually releases, but this video is to cover the new cosmetics and other things that you can get from the store currently. These will be available starting the day before the event, the 28th today. And I'm not sure if these items are going to stay in the store permanently or if they're only available during the event. Now, I'm going to let you guys know ahead of time, to get all these items, you're going to have to spend about 184,500 skill points. Now, I have not looked at exactly what that translates to real cash like I normally do, just because coming by currency in this game is actually so easy. You can just rack up on it. I myself had almost 700,000, so when the event came up, I just basically bought it all right out, no problem. So it's real easy to do, and if you guys want to get points, guys, just run a lot of side missions, run a lot of daily faction missions. Of course, you know, sell weapons that you pick up, don't dismantle them, sell them. You get a lot of money through doing those things. It's real easy. Loot all the chests at all the locations that you go to. It's just a real quick and easy way to load up on stuff just to sell it. With that out of the way, guys, I'm going to go over really quick the weapons that you're going to come by. This is not a review, it's just kind of an announcement, so I'm not going to spend a lot of time. But we got a new Resistance Assault Rifle, or Resistance ASR. That's going to cost you about 15,000. You also have the Stainless Extended 45, that's going to cost you about 8. Now, I'm going to let you know something about these weapons in a second, guys. You also have the Spaz 12 for 15,000. Now, the Spaz 12, you only get a couple attachments to adjust. The Stainless Extended has a real big issue I'm about to mention, but the Resistance ASR, all you can modify is the mag to two different sizes. So I just want to let that known. Now, when it comes to the pistol, there's also no sights for any of them, guys. All three are iron sights. So the pistol actually has no modification whatsoever. And what you see on top of it, which looks like a scope of sorts, is actually a laser. Now, this weapon and all these weapons are really designed after the ones used in the movies, and this one's from the first Terminator movie. So this laser is about the size of the gun itself, and when you go into first-person mode, guys, this weapon actually, the laser blocks almost the entirety of your sight that you need right in front of you. So that's just a public service announcement for that weapon alone. Spaz 12 works just like any other shotgun in the game, really. There's no sight for it, but you can make a couple adjustments to the weapon due to the mag size, the compensator, and stuff like that. So the weapons are there, guys. If you're a collector like me, you're going to buy them. It's going to cost you about 38,000 for those three alone. Next, we're going to go straight to the vehicles, just because there's only one that's come in, and that is the Gypsy Mark II Terminator. Now, this is the Gypsy class helicopter, guys, and it's a Mark II, which means it's going to fire two rockets at a time that lock on. So this isn't going to be the one that fires the barrage or the miniguns. And being a Gypsy type, of course, it will carry up to six people. So you can have a four-man squad and take two passengers as well for NPCs whenever you come across those missions. And this vehicle is going to cost you about 60,000. And two of the people that ride with you will be able to, of course, use turrets. After that, we have cosmetics for the way your guy looks. You have two different T-800 costumes. One of them comes with a jacket, one without. Both of which your character is messed up from top to bottom to allow you to see the exoskeleton underneath. Well, I guess it's not an exoskeleton in that case. It's just a skeleton in itself. But it looks really good, guys. It looks really cool. There's also two face paints in here. You have the red under eye, which honestly doesn't look that special. But you also have the shredded T-800. Now, this, of course, is just a painted onto your face, so even though it does look cool, guys, it doesn't look how I'd like it to. I'd like it to be a little concave, kind of to match the costume that you have on. That way it's kind of a little concaved into the face. It looks real, and maybe a red eye like you see in the movie. So that would have been a really cool change, but still, there's something else you can have. We also got shredded arm paint for both arms for 4,500 each. And you're going to come across a couple pairs of pants and some gloves and some boots. So that's it for all the cosmetic, guys. Just want to go ahead and just point it out. A quick video just talking about what you can get, what you can buy. If you guys are interested in this kind of stuff, and if you want new weapons, there's also going to be daily missions in the game. And the first mission, the first daily mission is going to give you an MK14 Terminator model. Now, we don't know what that looks like yet. We're going to have to wait to see what it looks like when it comes out. And then we'll have to get the blueprint for it. Hopefully, they're giving us the blueprint, not just the weapon, which seems to be a theme that they go with in this game, which is really good. Also, going to let you guys know that the blueprints now have a new area. So if you're on the PlayStation, you're going to hit R1. If you're on the Xbox One, you're going to hit RB whenever you get to the shop. And you're going to have a buy section. Now you're going to have a build weapon section. And you're going to have a sell section. And that first area over the build weapons where it says blueprints, those are you purchasing the blueprints themselves. Once you buy them, they're going to go into their respective categories. And then you can create them. Also, if you guys look all the way to the right of this area, you're actually going to see a new weapon category for grenade launchers. So I'm really interested to see if we're going to see the first grenade launcher actually in the actually part of this new live event that's only going to last a week, or if we're going to see that later on. But that's it for the video, guys. Sorry if it ran longer than intended. I just want to make sure I covered everything about it. If you guys like the video, please like, subscribe, comment below. I'm going to try to make some more Ghost Recon Breakpoint videos as the content becomes available. It kind of ran dry really quick, and I really do like these games. I just kind of want to get back into it. So kind of want to make some more video for you guys. So just let me know what you guys are interested in seeing, and I'll try to cover it. But like, subscribe, comment below. If you look in the description, you'll see a channel for my Discord. I just started one up recently. I want to get a community going. So if you guys want to do raids, PvP, run around some PvE, we can even set up groups to help other people work their way through side missions, faction missions, and story missions every day, maybe. But, yep, that's it for the video, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.